Hello everyone, today I'm going to explain Chapter 5 Yeti from Oxford New Pathways Coursebook. In 1974, teenager Lakhpal lived in a Nepalese village high in the Himalayan mountains. Each day, she climbed the pathway up the mountains to graze a herd of yaks. Now in 1974, there was a teenager girl. Teenager means belonging to the age group between 13 to 19. Her name was Lakhpal and she lived in a Nepalese village which is situated high in the Himalayan mountains. Now every day she used to climb up the pathway and she used to take her yaks for grazing to the mountains. Lakhpal saw few people on the steep mountain paths. Now she saw very few people on the steep mountain paths. What means steep? Steep means rising or falling quickly, or you can also say extreme rise or fall. Only Buddhist monks who chose to build their monasteries far away from the town and the cities lived this high up. Now, this was so high that only Buddhist monks, monks means religious people, who chose to build their monasteries. The buildings where these monks live are called monasteries. So only they build their monasteries that high up. Okay? Lakhpal had heard tales of the Yeti, an ape-like beast that lived in the Himalayas, but the mountains stretched for thousands of miles. Now Lakhpal had heard many stories of Yeti. Now who's Yeti? What's Yeti? Yeti is an ape-like beast that lived in the Himalayas. She never expected to see one herself. Now the mountains were stretched for thousands of miles and she never expected that she will ever come across a Yeti. One day as Lakhpal was grazing the herd, she noticed that the yak seemed restless. She thought that a bear or a snow leopard might be nearby. So once when she saw her yaks restless, she thought that a bear or a snow leopard might be around, and that is the reason why they are restless. Lakhpal led the yaks to a clear snow-fed stream. Now Lakhpal led the yaks to a clear snow-fed. Snow-fed means originated by melted snow. So she had a drink of water from that stream and then she watched as the yaks fed on the tough, that means hard mountain grass. Suddenly she heard a strange, deep, rough sound. Grunt is short and rough sound. She whirled around. Now she whirled around means moved around very quickly as a huge two-legged creature came rushing towards her. It was a Yeti. Terrified, she broke into a run. She got so scared when she saw that creature, two-legged creature, Yeti coming rushing towards her, that she started to run. She was so terrified, so scared that she started running. But it was too late. The Yeti grabbed Lakhpal in its long hairy arms. Now the Yeti was too close and the Yeti gripped her, or you can say caught her, in its long hairy arms. She screamed and kicked. She shouted. Scream means shouted. And she kicked, but the Yeti was too strong. Can you see in this picture how she's screaming, but the Yeti is too strong and she's kicking also, but the Yeti is not leaving her down. Then, without warning, the beast dropped her into the icy stream and turned to her yaks. Now, without even any warning, suddenly, the beast dropped her into the icy stream. The stream was icy cold because the water running down the stream originated by melted snow. So it was very cold. And the beast dropped her into that icy stream and turned towards her yaks with powerful blows. Blows means hit. With powerful blows, it quickly killed three of the enormous beast. Now, enormous means large and beast means animals. So, who were the enormous beast? The yaks, correct. Lakhpal crawled out of the stream and ran home as fast as she could. When the police investigated the scene, they found the Yeti's large footprints, but not the Yeti. Now, Lakhpal anyhow, she managed to crawl out of the stream and she ran home as fast as she could to save herself. Then when the police came and investigated the scene, they found the Yeti's large footprints, but they could not find Yeti. Hope you have understood the chapter up till here. The remaining part of this chapter will be covered in part 2. So do watch part 2 as well to understand the complete chapter. Thank you for watching my video. See you in the next video. Don't forget to like, share and comment on the video. Bye-bye.